Good afternoon, friends. Myself, Dr. Sanjay Yede, Associate Professor at MCA Department, DCP, HUPM Amravati. Today, we are going to see Java Database Connectivity. Welcome, friends. Today, we are going to learn the Java's multi-tier technology, that is JDBC, which stands for Java Database Connectivity. So, what is JDBC? It is an API which allows the Java programs to be connected to the different database management systems, or we can say to different data sources. Maybe they from the relational database management systems, maybe the Excel sheets, or even maybe the plain files. The JDBC is facilitated with the help of a library of classes and interfaces, which is called as Java JDBC API. That JDBC API is responsible for doing all the operations commonly associated with handling the databases. They may be making a connection to the database, they are creating SQL and MySQL statements, executing the SQL and MySQL queries, or viewing and modifying the results, resulting records. JDBC is a specification that provides complete set of interfaces and classes that allow for portable access to the underlying databases. The JDBC has its own architecture, which has two major components, namely JDBC API and JDBC driver API. JDBC API is responsible for making your application to the driver manager connection, all the transaction from your application to the Java's database driver is handled by JDBC API, and JDBC driver API handles the all communication from driver to the underlying database. The architecture is a multi-tiered one and is as depicted in this figure, which has at the top the Java application, which initiates the communication with the database, that is initiated with the help of the JDBC API, which these calls goes to the JDBC driver manager, and it in turn talk to the underneath databases. It talks in turn to the driver managers, which are the specific programs to interact with the underlying databases. These driver managers are specific for those particular databases, namely as shown in this diagram. This JDBC driver will interact with the Oracle driver, this will be interacting with the SQL Server database, and this database driver will be interacting with the ODBC data source. Even there can be the JDBC drivers which interact with the plain files. Maybe the file, notepad file in which the database is stored, that is accessed by the JDBC driver. The driver is nothing but a Java class which has the methods to interact with the data sources. To develop a JDBC application, we need to follow a set of steps as described here. For creating a JDBC application, we require a set of classes and interfaces which comprise a JDBC API, and that includes driver manager, driver class, connection class, statement class, result set class, and SQL exception. Driver manager, as explained in the previous slide, he handles the communication from the driver to the JDBC data sources. The driver is a program which is responsible for communicating from driver manager to the database. The connection is a class which establishes a connection from your Java program to the driver manager. The statement represents a SQL statement, an SQL query which is to be executed. The result set is the class which contains the result that is brought from data source to the data to your program and is stored into the result set object. SQL exception is a class which handles the errors. Then the main role of the main component of JDBC is the driver manager, whose role is to establish a connection between your application and the actual data source. That is handled with the help of a special program, special class called as the JDBC driver. There are different types of drivers available, and they are categorized as type 1 driver, type 2 driver, type 3 and type 4. The type 1 driver is a bridge between JDBC and ODBC. ODBC is Open Database Connectivity, which is a standard established by Microsoft to interact with different databases. And as that bridge is already available, this JDBC make use of that bridge to interact with different databases, and JDBC component, JDBC bridge component only makes connection between your application to the ODBC bridge. Then type 2 driver, it is called as the native API driver or the partly Java driver. We will see its explanation in the next slide. Then third comes the JDBC net or pure Java driver, which is the driver entirely written in Java language. And then the native protocol pure Java driver, which is the program which directly communicates from your program to the database management system. The type 1 driver, which is a JDBC ODBC bridge, is shown in this particular figure, where your Java application interacts with the bridge program, bridge driver, and that bridge inter communicates with the ODBC driver. ODBC driver is responsible for communicating with many type of different database management systems, and that all is done transparently, means what? You need not to bother about what type of database is stored underneath. Then the JDBC native API driver, in this the application, Java application interacts with a native API, and that interacts with directly with the database specific driver. Here you have to remember that or note that every database has to provide its own Java or JDBC compatible driver. If that is available, then that communication from your Java application to the database management system is possible. So they are already available, and this native API makes communication with the vendor driver, vendor specific driver. Then comes the JDBC net pure Java driver. Here the working of this driver is like that of the type 2 driver, again that is written in the pure Java language, and it interacts with a program which is responsible for selecting any type of driver, may it be type 1 driver, type 2 driver or type 4 driver. They will in turn interact with the underneath database, means this communication is a multi-layered, means from your Java application to the JDBC net pure Java driver, and then from it to a pool of different types of JDBC drivers, any one of them will be selected for communicating with the underneath database as is required. Then type 4 driver, it is said to be as the 100% pure Java driver, means in this case directly Java application is having the set of statements which can interact to the underlying database management system, means there is no database specific driver is required, but your Java program itself interacts with the underneath database. So, that is why it is called as the pure Java driver. Then now we will see the steps to create a JDBC application. So, first of all what we have to do is import a java.sql package. Why? It is having a set of classes in it and the interfaces in it which has the methods to communicate with the database management system and the database drivers. Second is register the JDBC driver. As we seen in the previous slides, that driver is the one which establishes the communication between your program and the underneath database management system. So, this driver is required to be registered, means what? It has to be made known to the Java virtual machine so that it can interact with the database. Then comes open a connection. Third step is to establish a connection between your application to the database driver, and that is the third step. Next is create a SQL statement to retrieve or store the data to the database. We require a set of SQL statements. They are required to be executed. To execute them, first of all we need the statement to be created, and here we have there are three different types of statements which can be created in Java. One is created with the statement object or statement class, in fact. Another is prepared statement class, and third is callable statement class. They have their own characteristics that can be seen detail in the consecutive lectures. Next step is to extract the data from the result set. After doing the creation and insertion of the data, we need to retrieve the data from the database, and to retrieve the data we may fire the select query which will bring in the set of records from the underneath database. That set of records or that result is stored in a special object called as the result set. That result set then is extracted to make use of what retrieved from the database. And then lastly, clean up the environment, means whatever you have established right now for communication is to be destroyed so that nothing should be left open and create any problem to our important data. So, for that purpose we need to close the connection, close the statement, close the driver. So, all that is done in the cleanup step. So, these are the set of steps for creating the JDBC application, and here we come to an end with the introduction of the Java database connectivity. So, thank you very much.